Hi everyone, this is Kavita again. Welcome to my biology class. So I hope like last class we have seen about the digestive system, how the human beings are obtaining their nutrition and how the digestive system works. So we just saw about I told you that digestive glands, it is of two parts. One is the alimentary canal and the other one is the associated glands. Digestive glands are the associative glands. So in the last class we have seen about like alimentary canal. So what are the parts are involved in the alimentary canal? And today we are going to see another part. It is a digestive gland, that is whatever the glands are associated with the digestion. So what that gland is helping to do, what is that helping to do in our body? Let us see all those things. Okay, come, we'll go into the class now. So first one, if you see, it is a salivary glands. So we have seen in the alimentary canal that buccal cavity helps for the digestion, we have seen. So in the buccal cavity we have the physical part like mouth and teeth to chew and to swallow the food inside, like tongue and the teeth to swallow the food inside. But there should be some enzyme to act upon that. That is called as a salivary gland. So salivary gland, if you see, it has three parts. It has three parts of a layer, and in that it secretes the enzymes called lysosome and salivary amylase. So these are the two enzymes that are secreted by the salivary glands. So what is this? Why it is secreting and what is the function of that? If you see in the lysosome, what they are doing, when the entry of the food particles, when we ingest our food particles into our mouth, this saliva secretes a salivary amylase, and that salivary amylase act upon the food particles for the killing of the bacteria. If any bacteria is present in the food particles, that can be killed by this lysosome. So there will not be any entry of the bacteria into our esophagus. And in the salivary amylase, what it is doing, if you see, the digestion starts from here. So the carbohydrates, whatever we are having, it has been converted, the complex molecule of starch is converted into a simple sugar like maltose like and glucose like that. Okay, so this is done by the salivary amylase. So carbohydrates are converted into simple sugars by salivary amylase. So whatever the carbohydrates present in your food particles can be digested with the help of this salivary amylase in your mouth cavity itself. Okay, so this is about the salivary glands. And next, if you see about the gastric secretion in stomach, what are the gastric secretion is there in the stomach? If you see here also, if three pairs it works, and that if you see what all it is, one is the mucus, and other one is the parietal cells. And the last one, if you see, it is a chief cells. So these three cells are working in the gastric secretion in stomach. So what it is? So if you see the mucus, mucus is a lining layer of our stomach. Why there is a lining layer of a stomach? Because you all know like hydrochloric acid secretion is there in the stomach. And stomach, it is a very soft skin and soft layer. It should not go and affect the layer of the stomach. So this mucus, what it will do, it will form a like protective layer for the stomach. So inside that gastric secretion, that is HCl, will be present inside and it will not affect the boundary area of our stomach. So that is the function of the mucus. So it forms a lining layer for the stomach. And second one, parietal cells, if you see, what is this parietal cells? In the sense, these cells are helpful for the secretion of hydrochloric acid in our stomach. So why that hydrochloric acid is needed in our body? For the digestion and also for killing of any bacteria. Suppose if lysosome cannot identify the bacteria and it did not kill, anyway it is going to entry into our food pipe and it will reach our stomach. So there again hydrochloric acid act upon that bacteria and it eradicate fully. So no bacteria will be present in our food particles. So that is done by the parietal cells, which secretes the hydrochloric acid. So here hydrochloric acid are secreted. And what is the chief cells? So chief cells are nothing, it is the cell to digest the proteins present in our food. So here what will happen, this proteins will be converted into pepsinogen here. So proteins directly it cannot be absorbed by our food, by our body, sorry. So that therefore the chief cells, what it will do, which is present in the stomach, it will secrete an enzyme which convert these proteins into pepsinogen. So first proteins will be converted into pepsin. Okay, after that pepsin will become inactive because of the, with the help of this hydrochloric acid and the chief cell, and it will be converted into pepsinogen. I hope you understood. Yes, next. It is the next gland, if you see, it is a liver. So liver associated with small intestine. Liver plays a main role in the digestion. Why? In the sense, so here what is happening, here one of the bile juice is secreted. In liver, if you see, a bile juice is secreted, and it is secreted by a gland called a gallbladder. It is the gallbladder. So gallbladder is an organ which is present in our stomach, which secretes the bile juice. So that bile juice, what it is doing in the sense, so we are eating the fatty substance, like a fatty food also. So that food also should be digested. So easily this carbohydrates can digest, proteins can digest. But when we have this fat substances, it cannot be easily digested. For that easy digestion, this bile juice is acting upon the fatty substances, and it is converting all the fats into fatty acids and glycerol. So this bile acts upon the fats and it converts into fatty acid plus glycerol. So this is what it is done by the bile juice, which is present in the gallbladder, which is secreted by the liver. So this will be secreted into the small intestine. So small intestine consists of all the juices, like all the, from all the glands it gets the juice, and it do the digestion process. So from the liver it gets the bile juice, from pancreas if you see it gets the pancreatic juice to convert again all the pepsinogen into amino acids. Into a simple food it has to be transformed. So we will be having the solid form. That solid form should be transformed into a liquid form, and it should be mixed with our blood cells, and it has to be transformed to all parts of our body. So that is done by these liver and pancreas, which is a very big gland in our body, which secretes the digestive enzymes. So from liver, it is bile juice is being secreted, and from pancreas, if you see, this pancreatic juice will be secreted. So until this, if you see, until the liver, it will be like acidic medium will be there. And acidic medium will be converted into a like small amount of alkaline medium. And when the pancreatic juice goes and falls on the small intestine, when those enzymes secreted in the small intestine, fully that acidic medium will be converted into alkaline medium. Okay, and it will be absorbed by our small intestine. So this is what the glands are doing. So first it is salivary glands, which act upon, salivary glands mainly it acts upon the carbohydrate substance. That carbohydrate substance are converted into simple sugars by salivary amylase and lysosome for the like killing of the bacteria. And next, if you see in the stomach, it is of three layers it is working. One is a mucus, it forms a lining layer of the stomach. And the second one is the parietal cells, which secrete hydrochloric acid, and that also kills the bacteria, and it is helpful for the digestion. And next one, if you see, it is a chief cells. So chief cells, which is present in the stomach, it will convert all the proteins into pepsinogen. And next, a liver, which is associated with small intestine, will secrete a bile juice from the gallbladder. It will secrete all the bile juice into the small intestine to emulsification of the fats. What is that? To convert fats into fatty acids and glycerol. And next, if you see this pancreatic juice, it is secreted from the pancreas to convert all the acidic medium to the alkaline medium. So now we will see like how this is taken place. What are the steps involved here? So you all know those steps. Already we have seen like how the amoeba is obtaining the nutrition. So the same five steps here also is involved. The thing is how these glands are associated with those steps. That is what we are going to see. Okay. So what are the five steps to obtain the nutrition? First is the ingestion. And next one is the digestion. Third one, it is absorption. Fourth one, if you see, it is assimilation. And the last one, if you see, it is egestion. Okay, so you all know these 5 steps. So how, what glands are associated with these 5 steps we are going to see. So ingestion, it is nothing, it's a buccal cavity mainly. So just we are absorbing the food particles, that is we ingest the food into our mouth. That process, first one is that ingestion. And in the digestion, if you see, well, like what gland will be associated with it, that is salivary gland is associated with the digestion step. Salivary gland is associated with the digestion step and it secretes the enzyme called salivary amylase to convert all the carbohydrates, that is the complex sugar, into the simple sugars. And if you see in this absorption, absorption is the main thing with here the small intestine and the stomach works. So first stomach absorb all the food particles, hydrochloric acid act upon it and the chief cells will act upon it and it will convert all the pepsin, inactive pepsin into pepsinogen. All the protein molecules will be converted. Next it will go into the small intestine where the liver and the pancreas secrete their juices into the duodenum part of the small intestine. Okay, so liver secretes the bile juice for the emulsification of the fats, fatty acids into glycerol. So here what are the glands it is working? It is like stomach, liver and pancreas. So these glands are associated with the small intestine and in the absorption process, like these three are working and they are secreting their digestive juices for the conversion of the complex molecules into the simple ones. So you can from the liver, the fatty molecules like fatty substances are converted into fatty acids and glycerol. In pancreas, if you see, it will secrete 3 enzymes. What are those 3 enzymes? I hope you all know it is trypsin. Then what are the other 2 enzymes, like trypsin and like pepsin also it has been done here. So this trypsin, if you see it, it converts, and also like third one is the amylase. So these three are the important enzymes which is secreted by the pancreas. So like trypsin, if you see, it converts all the proteins into amino acids, and pepsin, if you see, it converts all the inactive pepsin to the pepsinogen, like it will form into an active one, and amylase will convert all the complex molecules into a simpler one. So these are the 3 enzymes which is secreted by the pancreas. So these 3 collectively we call it as a pancreatic juices. Okay, so these 3 glands are associated for the absorption process. And the assimilation, what is it? Assimilation in the small intestine, we have seen one more part which is called as the villi. What is that villi? It is a finger like projections which is present inside the small intestine. So villi, here an important role is played by villi. So what is this? It is a finger like projection which is present in the small intestine after all these absorption process over. So a solid form will be converted into a semi-solid form in the stomach. So it is called as, in the stomach, food particles will be in the semi-solid form, which is called as bolus or chyme. C-H-Y-M-E, bolus or chyme, which is called as a bolus or chyme. So after absorption, after it moves into the small intestine, and when it comes for the assimilation process, this semi-solid part will be fully converted into a liquid part, which is being absorbed easily by this villi, because this villi is supplied with the blood capillaries. You all know villi is supplied with the blood capillaries. So with the help of this blood capillaries, the liquid form of the food particles can be absorbed easily and it can be sent to all parts of the body, since the blood capillaries are associated with the villi part which is present in the small intestine. And the last one, you all know, it is ingestion. Here only one gland is there, that is large intestine. So already we have seen the 3 parts like colon, rectum, all those things. So with the help of this colon and rectum, what it will do, it will collect all the feces by the colon, by the rectum, and the colon will collect all the water molecules and it will send out out of the body through the part called anus. So that is what the ingestion process. So ingestion process is associated with a gland called large intestine. I hope you have understood. So these are the 5 steps. With this 5 steps, these are the glands are associated for the digestion. Understood? Yes. So I hope you have understood today's topic, like what I taught. So if you have any queries, you can ask me doubt. You can post your doubts in the comment box. So in the next class, I'll come with a new topic. Thank you.